Every night the fisherman called the mermaid, and she sang as he worked. She sang of her home in the Sea King's palace, where filigree fans of coral wave all day and fish dove like silver birds. She sang of tritons with long green beards who blow great blasts on conch shells in celebration or alarm. Sometimes the fisherman paused to let the mermaid's voice fill his mind with images of things he had never seen or even imagined. Anemones clinging to rocks, sea horses with floating manes, whales riding down from the northern seas with sharp icicles hanging.